Now I go back 35 years. Now, I don't go back, you know. It's a matter of... In the middle of 1942, I was thinking to continue my service as a courier between the Polish underground and the Polish government in exile in London. The Jewish leaders in Warsaw learned about it. A meeting was arranged outside of the ghetto. There were two gentlemen. They did not live in the ghetto. They introduced themselves. Leader of Bund, Zionist leader. Now, what transcribed, what happened in our conversation? First, I was not prepared for it. I was relatively isolated in my work in Poland. I did not see many things. In 35 years after the war, I don't go back. I have been a teacher for 26 years. I never mention the Jewish problem to my students. I understand this film. It is for historical record, so I will try to do it. They describe to me what is happening to the Jews. Did I know about it? No, I didn't. They describe to me first that the Jewish problem is unprecedented, cannot be compared with the Polish problem or Russian or any other problem. Hitler will lose this war, but he will exterminate all Jewish population. Do I understand it? The Allies fight for their people. They fight for humanity. The Allies cannot forget that the Jews will be exterminated totally in Poland, Polish and European Jews. They were breaking down. They paced the room. They were whispering. They were hissing. It was a nightmare for me.
Did they look in complete desperation?
Yes. Yes, at various stages of the conversation, they lost control of themselves. I just sat in my chair. I just listened. I did not even react. I didn't ask them questions. I was just listening. Well, and then
they wanted to convince you, to convey...
They realized from the beginning that I don't know, that I don't understand this problem. Once I said I will take messages from them, they wanted to inform me what is happening to the Jews. And I didn't know this. I was never in a ghetto. I never dealt with the Jewish matters.
And did you know yourself at the time that most of the Jews of Warsaw had already been killed?
I did know, but I didn't see anything. I never heard any description of what is happening over there. I was never there. It is one thing to know statistics. There were hundreds of thousands of Poles also killed, of Russians, Serbs, Greeks. We knew about it. But it was a question of statistics.
But did they insist about the complete uniqueness of the...
Of yes, the this was their problem. To impress upon me, and then was my mission, to impress upon all people whom I am going to see, that the Jewish situation is unprecedented in history. Egyptian pharaohs did not do it. Babylonians did not do it. Now, for the first time in history, actually, they came to the conclusion, unless the allies take some unprecedented steps, regardless of the outcome of the war, the Jews will be totally exterminated. And they cannot accept.
This means that they ask for very specific measures.
Yes.
For the...
So then, interchangeably, at a certain point, the Bund leader, at a certain point, the Zionist leader, then what do they want? What message am I supposed to take? Then they gave me messages, various messages. To the allied governments as such, I was to see as many government officials as I could, of course. Then to the Polish government, then to the president of the Polish Republic, then to the international Jewish leaders, and to individual political leaders, leading intellectuals, approach as many people as possible. And then they gave me segments. To whom do I report what? So now, in this nightmarish, two meetings I had with them, nightmarish meetings, well, then they presented their demands, separate demands. The message was, Hitler cannot be allowed to continue extermination. Every day counts. The Allies cannot treat this war only from purely military strategic standpoint. They will win the war if they take such an attitude. But what good will it do to us? We will not survive this war. The Allied governments cannot take such a stand. We contributed to humanity. We gave scientists for thousands of years. We originated great religions. We are humans. Do you understand it? Do you understand it? It never happened before in history what is happening to our people now. Perhaps it will shake the conscience of the world. We understand. We have no country of our own. We have no government. We have no voice in the Allied councils. So we have to use services, little people like you are. Will you do it? Will you approach them? Will you fulfill your mission? Approach the Allied leaders. We want an official declaration. Of the Allied nations that in addition to the military strategy which aims at securing victory, military victory in this war, extermination of the Jews forms a separate chapter. And the Allied nations formally, publicly announce that they will deal with this problem, that it becomes a part of their overall strategy in this war. Not only defeat of Germany, but also saving the remaining Jewish population. Once they make such an official declaration, they have air force. They drop bombs on Germany. Why cannot they drop millions of leaflets informing the German population exactly what their government is doing to the Jews? Perhaps they don't know it. No. Let them make official declaration, again, official, public declaration, that if the German nation does not offer evidence of trying to change the policy of their government, German nation will have to be held responsible for the crimes their government is committing. And now, if there are not such an evidence, to announce publicly, officially, certain objects in Germany will be bombed, destroyed, as a retaliation for what the German government is doing against the Jews. That bombing which will take place is not a part of the military strategy. It deals only with the Jewish problem. Let the German people know before bombing takes place and after bombing takes place that this was done and will continue to be done because Jews are being exterminated in Poland. Perhaps it will help. They can do it. This they can do it. This was one mission. Next. Both of them. particularly the Zionist leader. He was again like whispering, hissing to me. Something is going to happen. The Jews in the Warsaw Ghetto are talking about it. Particularly young elements. They will fight. They speak about declaration of war against the Third Reich. Unique war in the world history. Never such a war took place. They want to die fighting. We cannot deny them this kind of death. By the way, I didn't know at that time Jewish military organization emerged. They didn't tell me about it, only that something is going to happen. The Jews will fight. They need arms. We approached the commander of the Home Army, the underground movement in Poland. Those arms were denied. Refused. They cannot be denied arms. If such arms exist, and we know you have arms. This message to Commander-in-Chief, General Sikorsky, to issue orders that those arms will be given to the Jews. This was another part of the mission. There are international Jewish leaders. Reach as many as possible. Tell them this. They are Jewish leaders. Their people are dying. There will be no Jews. So what for do we need leaders? We are going to die as well. We don't try to escape. We stay here. Let them go. To important offices. In London, wherever they are. Let them demand for action. If it is refused, let them walk out. Stay in the street. Refuse food. Refuse drink. Let them die. In view of all humanity. Who knows? Perhaps it will shake the conscience of the world. Between those two Jewish leaders, somehow, this belongs to human relations, I took, so to say, to the Bund leader. Probably because of his behavior. He looked like a Polish nobleman, a gentleman, straight, beautiful gestures, dignified. I think that he liked me, also personally. Now, at a certain point, he suggested it. He says, Mr. Witold, I know the Western world. You are going to deal with the English. Now, you will give them your oral reports. I am sure it will strengthen your report if you will be able to say, I saw it myself. We can organize for you to visit the Jewish ghetto. Would you? If you do, to the Jewish ghetto in Warsaw, I will go with you. So I will be sure that you will be as safe as possible. A few days later, he will establish contact. By that time, Jewish ghetto, as it existed in 1942 until July, did not exist anymore. Out of approximately 400,000 Jews, in the meantime some 300,000 were already deported from the ghetto. So within the outside walls, practically there were some four units. The most important was the so-called central ghetto. They were separated by some areas inhabited by the Aryans already, some areas not inhabited by anybody. There was some building. This building was constructed in such a way that the wall which separated the ghetto from the outside world was a part of the back of the building. so the front was facing the Aryan area. There was some tunnel. We went through this tunnel without any kind of difficulties. What struck me, completely different men. The Bund leader, the Polish nobleman. I go with him. He is broken down, curbing like a Jew from the ghetto, as if he lived there all the time. Apparently this was his nature. This was his world. So we walked the streets. He was on my left. We didn't talk very much. He led me. Well, so what? So now comes the description of it, yes? Naked bodies on the street. I ask him, why are they here?
Corpses, you mean?
Corpses. Says, well, they have a problem. If the Jew dies and the family wants some burial, they have to pay tax on it. So they just throw them in the street.
Because they cannot pay the tax.
Yeah. They cannot afford it. So then they say, every rag counts. So they take their clothing. And then once the body, the corpse, is on the street, yes, Juden Rat has to take care of it. Women with their babies. Publicly feeding their babies. But they have no breast. It's just flat. Babies with some crazy eyes looking.
Did it look like a complete strange world?
What?
Other world, I mean.
It was not a world. This was not humanity. Streets full. Apparently all of them lived in the street. Exchange, what was the most important? Everybody offering something to sell. 3 onions, 5 onions, some cookies. Selling, begging each other. Crying, I'm hungry. Was horrible, children. Some children running by themselves. Or with their mothers sitting. It wasn't humanity. It was some hell. Now, this part of the ghetto, German offices were there in the central ghetto. If Gestapo released somebody, and Gestapo officers, they had to pass through the ghetto to get out of it. So there were also Germans, German traffic. Now, the Germans in uniform. They were walking. Silence. Everybody frozen until he passed. No movement, no begging, nothing. Germans. Contempt. This is those apparently dirty subhuman. They are not human, this. Now, at a certain point, some movement starts. Jews are running from the street I was on. We jumped into some house. He just hits the door, open the door, open the door. They open the door. We moved in. Windows go, give to the back of the street. We go to the opposite, in the door. Some woman opened the door. Says, all right, don't be afraid. We are Jews. He pushes me to the window. Look at it, look at it. There were two boys. Nice looking boys. Hitlerjugend uniforms. They walked. Every step they made, Jews disappearing, running away. They were talking to each other. At a certain point, a boy gets to his pocket without even thinking. Shoots. Some broken glass, some shouting, The other voice, something, congratulating him. They go back. So I was paralyzed. So then a Jewish woman, probably she recognized me, I don't know that I'm not a Jew. She embraced me, go, go, it doesn't do you any good, go, go. So we left the house. Then we left the ghetto. So then he said, you didn't see everything, you didn't see too much. Would you like to go again? I will go with you. I want you to see everything. I will. Next day we went again. The same house, the same way. So then again, now I was more conditioned. So I felt other things. Stench, stench. Dirt, stench. Everywhere, suffocating. Dirty streets. Nervousness, tension. Some bedlam. This was Plac Muranowski. In a corner of it, some children play something. With some rags, throwing the rags to another, he says, they are playing as you see. Life goes on, life goes on. So then I said, they are simulating playing, they don't play.
It was a special place for playing?
In the corner of Plac Muranowski. No, 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 open. So I say they
there
are
trees.
There were a few trees, Rashidic trees. So then we just walked the streets. We didn't talk to anybody. We walked probably 1 hour. Sometime he would tell me, looked at this Jew, a Jew standing without moving. I said, is he dead? He says, no, he's alive. Mr. Witold, remember, he's dying. Look at him. Tell them over there. You saw it, don't forget. We walk again. It's macabre. Only from time to time, he would whisper, remember this? Or he would tell me, look at her. Very many cases. I would say, what are they doing here? His answer, they are dying. That's all right, they are dying. Then always, but remember? We spent more, perhaps 1 hour. We left the cat. Frank and I couldn't take it more. Get me out of it. And then I never saw him again. I understand your role. I am here. I don't go back in my memory. I couldn't take any more. But I reported what I saw. Yes, it was not a world. It was not a part of humanity. I was not part of it. I did not belong there. I never saw such things. I never... Nobody wrote about this kind of reality. I never saw any theater. I never saw any movie. This was not the world. I was told that these are human beings. They didn't look like human beings. And we left. He embraced me then. Good luck. I never saw him again.